Hello and welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, two reasons I want to do this one. I've got what is a fantastic beer, and I want to redo the can on one of them because I've got four cans. One of them, the one that I've done a review on, was a bit farty, a bit kind of sulfurous and that. I wouldn't imagine that's a regular thing with Adnams because they are quality brewers. And the other, well, two of the other three, I've got one left. Two of the other three was lovely, gorgeous. And the first one was still lovely in that, but it just, the fartiness put me off a bit. It was kind of like a little bit too much Burton Snatch in there and stuff like that, you know. So anyway, we're going to get on. I'm going to do a comparison because we've got what was happened until I tasted those other two. Well, no, I ain't going to give the game away. We've got the lovely, fantastic and beautiful Adnams Ghost Ship in bottle. That is 4.5 ABV. And we've got a bit of a special. They've now gone into cans, but it's not the same beer. Well, it is. It's brewed the same and everything else, but there's a thing called dry hopping. terrible speaker, isn't I? Dry hopping, not dry hopping, where you stick, you know, the actual hop cones, the binds and all that, you throw the dry hops in there, and they kind of all infuse in, not during the brew and all that, you know, but while it's sitting there kind of doing its thing, and then it gets bottled up or canned up in this one. Now, I don't think they've done it with the bottles, but I've been told they've done it with the cans. So there's the can. It's also 4.5. I'll tell you if the bottle's different, because I remember what it tasted like. And it was lovely and glorious and beautiful. Have a look back on my review. I may do another review of the Ghost Ship in can, if this one's alright as well, because two out of the three of them that I've tried was great. And I'm hoping this one's going to be great as well. I'm pretty sure it will be. Right, so let's pour them out. I haven't got the same glass, so I don't mind. They're kind of similar glasses, both very pretty. Look at that, actually in accord with each other as well, in harmony. One's woo, and the other's ee. Yeah, all right, yeah. Notes I can't get to. Right, I'm really looking forward to this. So I'm going to put the short one in the short thing. There's a little tiny bit, so that the can's going to go in that pretty little glass there. And the bottle's going to go in that taller glass there with. I ain't going to show you what's on the side. But I do like this. A pretty glass apart from one bit on the side there. Yeah. So, can in the short one. Let's crack that and see how it goes. This time not smelling any fart or anything either. Now, I'll tell you what is really glorious about this. Is that hop is resinous almost. It's kind of really punching, hefty, lovely, big, poor, chewy hop. Now, let's show you what that looks like. Got a lovely big tall head on it. Something white. There we go. Reach over the top there. Pulled this off the wall. Just before Christmas. Right, here we go. It's a picture of a baby in it, you know. Right. It's all right. I'll get another one up there. I've got loads of copies. That's, right, the colour that I'm getting is a little bit of this, but kind of see the top of that flame there on the actual glass. Nearer to that. The top bit of it. Not the bright middle bit. That's the colour you're getting. Right, have a quick sniff while I've got it fresh. Oh, massive, big, hoppy character in there. But the head is kind of becoming a bit of a quilt in a way. It's like trying to listen to music with your head under a bath of water in it, you know. It's like, boof. It's like a big creamy head on it that doesn't seem to dissipate. Right, big hop presence. It's kind of a, like a big, one of these kind of American sort of hops. You're getting a big, punchy, fruity character, but a nice bitterness as well. A lovely bitterness. Now I'm going to pour the other one out. The bottle, let's just move that can over there. Right, let's crack that open. Talk amongst yourselves. I'm just preparing for it here. That is, as you've always already seen, that's the crown. Put him up there. Nice on the nose, not quite as much of a big hoppy presence as the other one. That actually is like poking a hop up your nose and going smash like that, you know. He's in a nice way though. Not quite as heady on this. Same colour, exactly the same colour you're getting. I've poured a little bit more head in, but it's kind of lacy and dissipating down fairly quickly. Nice carbonation going through the glass there. Nice, kind of really nice, gentle little fizzle. Let's have a little spin on the nose. Now the nose is nowhere near as buoyant, and nowhere near as kind of chewy and kind of fruity. Nice gentle bitterness. Let me just spin this one again. Loads different on the nose, loads different. This one, the can, is really punching. It's almost chewy on the nose. Big apricot sort of notes in there. This is still nice, but it's more subtle, it's more relaxed on the nose. Right, let's go in. Let's go in with the bottle first. Oh, it's gorgeous. That is absolutely gorgeous. I really like that. I really do like that. That is such a pleasant drink. It's got all those lovely, and a lovely bitterness afterwards, but it's got a lovely kind of scratchy finish, dry finish, but it's almost a carrot-like finish on it. But it's got a big, hefty, fruity foreground that comes in with lychees and, funny enough, carrot cake as well. Lychees, carrot cake, a bit of apricot, a bit of orange zest as well. Then you got a zesty bitter finish on it that hangs around. Let's have a little taste of this. Chin chin. Jesus, that is much better. That is much better. Right. You got the same stuff going on, but magnified. Imagine like looking at an ant. And you go, oh, then that's small. Look here, a big, great big one in my head from a great big magnifying glass. Wow, like that. Look at the head on it and all that, you know. That is gloriously glorious. Yes, that. Try it, like it. Buy that instead of the bottle, I think. And also it's cheaper as well. And I'm one of these people that I'm kind of a bit old-fashioned when it comes to the bottle. Notice if I said old-fashioned as I was scratching at me, pulling at me old grey beard. They're almost not the same drink. One's really mellowed down, and it's beautiful, really beautiful, but it's much more mellowed. The can is quite challenging. But it's also, excuse me, a bit windy. It's also just so delightful. It's just so big, boisterous and chewy. It's just an orgy of hops on the tongue bouncing around and hip-hopping around and all that, you know. That is glorious. Buy it, try it, love it. Buy both of them, try both of them, love both of them. That one, buy it, try it, like it, without a doubt. Buy it, try it, love it. Love it. Go for it if you like your big hops. Go for it. Cheers, bottoms up, chin chin. Till next time, I'll see you soon.